Kia ora, good evening. Helen Clark has had a major change of heart on the future of the Māori seats, saying they do now need to be entrenched. Just a week ago, she said they didn't. National says it's a shameless attempt to kiss the Māori Party's bottom line, but Clark says it's not a policy flip-flop because she's just discovered it's been Labour policy for years. Live in the studio is political editor Duncan Garner. Duncan.
Good evening, Carolyn. Well, look, Helen Clark is very keen to have this painted today as an old Labour idea, but for months now, indeed years, she actually hasn't publicly supported entrenchments of the seats, and exactly a week ago she was still holding that line. Today, of course, it's all changed, and National says she's taking desperate measures because it's desperate times for Labour. Helen Clark had been saved the plum seat at this Tongan Church gathering in South Auckland, but it's the Māori seats that she now really wants to save in a major backdown on her previous position this campaign.
I have absolutely no difficulty with entrenching these seats. It's the position we took in 2001. I've been back and looked at the provisions. I frankly think it is an inequity that those provisions are not entrenched.
Clark is clinging to that 2001 Select Committee report where Labour agreed in principle to entrench the seats. As evidence, this is no flip-flop. Entrenching the seats is the bottom line to gain the support of the Māori Party, but a week ago, entrenchment was not Clark's policy.
There's obviously no need to entrench them under a Labour government because we're absolutely committed to the seats staying.
But Clark says she's since done more research.
Now, going forward, it's clear that we have much more militant right-wing parties which are very opposed to the Māori seats, and I think it makes sense to entrench.
Once the seats are entrenched, it would require 75% of Parliament to take that away. It would guarantee the Māori seats indefinitely and the Māori Party. And Clark is clearly pitching to get the Māori Party's support for a post-election deal.
Wouldn't a sceptic say a week out from the election the Prime Minister needs the support of the Māori Party, and she's quickly gone back and looked at what the Labour Party did 7 or 8 years ago and has come up with this new position a week out from the election to get the Māori Party support?
It's not a new position for Labour. We supported entrenchment in 2001.
But Clark says she'd forgotten about that, and the Māori Party's calling it a timely memory gain.
To have the Prime Minister now come out and say that this was done in 2001 and people agreed, and looks like that she wants to agree again. So that sounds good.
But John Key says it's just shameless.
It's a very strong sign of desperation from Helen Clark.
So the Māori Party is likely to be the kingmaker after the election, and Helen Clark is redesigning the crown to make sure it fits.
So there's actually another reason why Labour has also done this today. Remember, it had hitched its wagon to New Zealand First as a potential coalition partner after the election. But look, New Zealand First and Peters are in real trouble. None of the polls are indicating that Peters will be back, and Clark needs new options and she needs them fast. Certainly Labour strategists that I've spoken to today are privately concerned that Peters can't be relied on to get there and indeed may not make it to Parliament at all. Look, Clark, though, does risk a potential backlash, perhaps from Middle New Zealand, on what many might see as a change of heart and, as National said, perhaps desperation.
And Duncan, some moves from both Labour and National today concerning the economy.
Yes, look, Clark fleshed out more detail on rushing forward infrastructure spending next year to keep Kiwis basically in jobs. She wants to inject millions of dollars into roading projects, the rollout of broadband and that billion-dollar program to insulate old and damp houses. National responded by saying it will give schools an additional $500 million to spend on buildings and other projects.
OK, Duncan, thank you.